Well, welcome to the KerrFatou build-up to the African Nations Cup qualifiers between the Gambia and South Sudan. Coming up on Saturday, the 4th June, we are at the Lakjor Stadium in Chess, the venue for this match. And one man who has been involved in the organization of this particular match, from the preparations in Dubai right down to the organization here in Senegal, is the first vice president of the Gambia Football Federation, Bakary Jammeh. Bakary, let's start with these logistics. Having to organize a home match abroad. I mean, a situation where even you yourself and your supposed visitors are both strangers. Suddenly that would be some work for you and your men. Can you take us through how did you take on these preparations?
Like you said, it is not the ideal situation that we are in as a federation, as a country. However, the reason is known and the rest is history. Today we are here, I think fully prepared for the match tomorrow. It's difficult because first we have to actually get the Senegalese Football Federation to agree to host us, not only us, but South Sudan, who by right, as a visiting team, is entitled to all the necessary protocols.
That you would have given to them in Banjul.
Indeed. All the responsibility that we had in Banjul, we have that one in here as well. And it's Senegal, it's more expensive, and the logistics also is not easy, traveling from one place to another. There is more traffic actually in here. But first, I would like to say that because of the good brother relationship we had as people and the good relationship we have between the two federation, and particularly the two leaders of the federation and the entire leadership, we approached the Senegalese. There was a visit here as well by the Events Management Committee of the GFF, together with the National Sports Council, to ensure that we have a venue in place. This is our first choice, of course, dictated by a number of factors. Forcing it is the demand for the Gambian people. Our fans want to see the national team play. You know what happened when we went to Morocco for the qualifiers. Yes. So we are grateful that the Senegalese decided to host us, and they're also helping us in a number of ways. Mm-hmm. Most of the facilities we have to pay, but at a very concessionary fee.
Right.
Yeah, so in fact, we were pleasantly surprised that the budget is less than what we originally discussed.
Okay.
They have provided not only the field, but you can see security, protocol from the airport for both teams to our respective hotels, coming for training and going back, and they are consistently checking on us to ensure that everything is going fine. Mm-hmm. So as a federation, we are supposed to provide all the necessary logistics, and that is happening. And then I'm glad that the coach, I'm sure you have spoken to him, that he is also going through his technical preparations nearly hitch-free. I mean, there is nothing 100%, but pretty good. I mean, from leaving Banjul to Dubai, perhaps we will talk about that as well along in the interview.
All the protocols you should have provided for the South Sudanese, if they are in Banjul, you still have to do that here. How have you handled them?
From airport reception. So we're supposed to receive them at the airport and facilitate their visa into Senegal. Some of their players are coming as far as Tehran, and they didn't arrive at the same time. So you can see it's a hell lot of a job. So we had members of the GFF to the Event Management Committee in country a few days before today to ensure that the South Sudanese delegation not only have all the means of transportation, because we have to provide a bus for them, and also we have to provide the small car for them. So we receive them from the airport. Of course, they are responsible for their own hotel to ensure that they are actually camped in their hotel. So we have GFF personnel actually going to international airport in Jazz to collect them and take them to Sali. Mm-hmm. Also, today, as per the protocols of football, they are entitled to train here at 4. You've seen 1 hour before us, and then it was well choreographed. They trained after 1 hour. Now we are actually training. We also checked on them in their hotel, because this is in line with the protocols of football. We will be great rivals when the referee blaze the whistle for us to beat them. Yeah. I must add. But so far, so good. We are very experienced in organizing games. Okay. We are experienced in organizing tournaments. We've seen how it is done in country, and many of us, including myself, international match commissioners in tournaments at the highest level. So. And a lot of my colleagues, you know, Musa Jammeh is the CAF security officer. And then he goes to tournaments. My colleague Ibu Fai is a general coordinator for CAF. So far so good. As far as the South Sudanese, and we didn't have any complaint from them for the time being.
Okay, let's talk about having Gambians involved. I understand the GFF has put up a package for Scorpions fans club, official fans club, to be here. How did you go about it?
That is why I said we have to be home away from home. We have to ensure that we create the environment like how it should be. It will not be like Independence Stadium, but we'll have to try to make it as likely like it was Independence Stadium as possible. That is why we have an official fan club, which is recognized by the GFF. As an executive committee, we took it, it's our responsibility to ensure that they come in to chair the team. And the boys wonder. I mean, we also have to also get our core members, the members of the team and the association. So this is what happens in Banjul. If you have a home game, all our stakeholders, primary stakeholders, should come and watch. So we also have to facilitate that for that to happen. And we are grateful that most of the people are traveling. Some are already here, as you can see, and people are on their way. And then tomorrow morning, early morning, a lot of people are going to travel to come to Gambia, because this is Independence Stadium for us now. Yeah. And it is our responsibility to ensure that we try to put in the conditions like in the Independence Stadium. It's a logistic challenge, but as leaders of football, this is what is expected of us, and we are doing a shot of it. At the end of the day, we look back and see how successful it was. We hope that we didn't have to do this again in September, because we are aware of the fact that the government, who's responsible for the Independence Stadium, are doing some moves to ensure that the Independence Stadium is compliant for CAF A matches. You know, CAF A matches, which is a CAF A. The other matches we can host, but these we cannot host this sort of matches. So September will be home at home.
Now let's talk about immediately from here, Saturday, and we're looking out to make arrangements for traveling, for the team to travel to Congo Brazzaville. I mean, there's only 3 days between this match and that of Congo. What are the preparations like for that one?
Well, the game here tomorrow and Congo is on the same match days. Yeah. That means we play here and then we go and Congo Brazzaville. You can see, we looked at this as 3 matches. We came back from Dubai, which was a friendly game. This Dubai game, I think it's important that people to note that this is part of our strategic objective to ensure that we give the team as much preparations as possible before any official games. Even when there are no official games, I think barring in one instance, since we took over, every FIFA window, we try to utilize by doing many things to ensure that we meet. That is why we raised in the last few years about 49 points in the FIFA ranking. And we wanted to repeat that as quickly as possible so that we can be We can even surpass where Gambia's highest point is. That is an objective. And you can only do that by playing. And but also the second benefit for that is that it gives the coach the opportunity to scout players, to actually practice his tactics. There are a lot of things that is done in Dubai will not be done today. We already, he will have a fairly good idea of who's starting 11 and who plays what, and gives you an opportunity to talk and bond as well, because these boys haven't played for some time. Some of them are coming back from holidays because their seasons are, some are still playing, or some just ended their seasons. So it allows them to actually gel. And then we are pleased that our sister federation in Dubai Football Association has decided to host us. They paid for the airfares of our delegation that left from Banjul, right, to Dubai and to Senegal. And all the players that are in Europe, from Brussels to Dubai to Senegal. And they hosted us as well. They paid for all the hotels. And then they also, there was no match preparation cost because of the good relationship we have with our sister organizations, and that we're able to save us a lot of money in the process. Going to Brazzaville now, as you asked. Yes, I mean, we are grateful that all the other things, the government of the Gambia, through the Ministry of Youth and Sport, are helping. They're working with the GFF. They're taking care of the core expenses and logistics, like airfares, and like, for example, the allowances, the camping allowances, the draw or win bonuses, and even some other logistics, while the GFF ensures that our core part, which is the provisions for the match officials in line with the CAF protocols, we take care of that. So we're doing a partnership with the government of the Gambia, and all is going pretty well.